The climate crisis affects us all. But those who have contributed least to global heating must be compensated for the loss and damage they are facing as a result of historical emissions.
90 casas, más de 130 familias lo perdieron absolutamente. Escuelas, iglesias, andenes peatonales, caminos, todos se perdieron.
আমাদের কোনো নিশ্চয়তা নাই, বুঝেছ? এখানে আমাদের হয়তো বাইরে শেল্টার নেওয়ার চেষ্টা করতে হবে।
Those who bear the least responsibility for the climate emergency are being impacted first and worst. But negotiations to address this injustice and agree on compensation have dragged on for decades.
Everything burns.
To alleviate the inevitable and disastrous impacts of the climate catastrophe, COP27 must finally deliver an effective framework for loss and damage.
Basically, compensation to the poor and vulnerable people of this planet who have suffered unthinkable losses as a result of climate change that they have contributed to in no way at all.
Developed nations have committed a crime, but they're not paying for it. We are paying for it. The justice there is you coming to recognize that, okay, I've done something wrong, I need to pay for it, I need to act. You pay the penalty. And the penalty is for the developed nation to provide support.
Wealthier nations must reach agreements on compensation for the most severely impacted countries to allow them to invest in their own climate resilience and reconstruction.
The climate finance that we are, you know, all campaigning about, $100 billion. That is the least that you can pay because people have lost lives. You cannot compensate a life.
If we don't come up with some kind of system for loss and damage after 29 years, then every single negotiator should walk away from that meeting, hanging their heads in shame.